Going on, guys. We are back with another reaction. So far I've reacted to the songs on the album. Now we're at the first speaking session, which is basically an interview that Juice WRLD had with somebody. I don't know if it was about this album, because she refers to if he talks about like anxiety and depression and stuff in this album. But again, you could have said that about any album, and he has talked about it in every album that he's released. So I don't know if that's necessarily about this album, but I just wanted to kind of point that out. So let's listen to this. I've already heard what it's got to say, but I think it's worth having you guys hear it. You know what I'm saying? It's really touching.
I never really had nothing to hide. Like, it was never really no filter in my head. Like, would it be not cool to talk about your emotions? Or, you know, like, it was never nothing in my conscience, in my head to tell me not to do that. Going through some music not only is something that kind of helps the situation pass, I also make music talking about certain subjects because I know that I'm not the only one going through, you know, what's happening. Me talking about...
What he just said, I make music because I know I'm not the only one that's going through what's happening. Again, he makes music that others can relate to. That's not, I'm going to go fucking kill somebody, shoot them up, even though that's what he talks about. I don't really think that he would go that far, but hey, I don't know. He hangs out with Trippy, so. I don't really fuck with his music, but I know he's a real blood. At least that's what it's said. He's, you know, anyways. What was it? Holy fuck, dude, it's getting windy in here. God damn it. Fucking wind. I don't even have a jacket. I'm actually getting kind of chilly. Fuck me. I'm here. I was going to wear shorts, dude. And I was like, you know what? It's starting to get a little nippy. I threw on my fucking Tech Fleece joggers, bro. All black ones that I got today. Which I got because I have the all black jacket. But I also have the black and gray. Anyways, nobody gives a fuck about my Tech Fleece fucking joggers. So, I completely forgot what the fuck I was talking about, dude. Fuck me. Hold up.
Certain things can help somebody else do what they're going through.
Okay. Sorry, guys. I had to refresh myself by listening to some of it. So, making music that others can relate to, and he's talking about that shit, is awesome as fuck. Like, not only is it interesting to hear somebody else's perspective of something that I might be going through, but for you to acknowledge that you are making this music not only just to talk about what you're experiencing, but also to help others that are going through the same or similar things. Like, the one thing that I feel really makes this music something that's helped me to cope with my depression, ironically, you know, because inevitably, you know, it's no fucking surprise to say this is really depressing music. It's not something that a lot of his music is like happy, uplifting kind of deal. You know what I'm saying? This ain't no BTS. But, I guess you could dance to it if you really wanted to. I don't know. Do the Harlem Shake. Said that in one other video. Anyways, but yo, I respect that, man. Anyways, let's continue on with this interview.
As well as me trying to figure it out myself.
You were telling me a little bit about, you know, just how you've struggled with anxiety over the years. Do you feel like you touch on that a little bit in this album?
Yeah, I do touch on it.
Mm-hmm.
I do. That's something that I feel like a lot of people neglect, which is completely, utterly wrong. And me speaking from an African-American man, I know that this stuff is neglected. In like our community, you know, you tell your mom, your dad, your auntie, whoever, that you feel like you got anxiety, you feel like you got depression, you feel like you got ADD, whatever. They don't look at you like you're crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you don't got that. Get out of here. Like, are you going to tell me I don't got something, you know? That's not how it should be, but that's how it is.
What he said right there, that people neglect anxiety and depression as a thing, and others do openly shrug it off. Admittedly, I've done that too, where it's like, you know what, I didn't really think, okay, I'm actually kind of getting scared that I'm going to fucking fly away in a tornado. Dude, it's getting hella windy. I'm going to go to the fucking side. But I guess I could just do this in my room too, right? I'm smoking the vape. I can smoke my vape in my room because it doesn't smell up the room. You know what I'm saying? But it is interesting to hear his interviews, man. I think that Juice has a very wise way of saying things definitely an intelligent individual, you know what I'm saying? Not an idiot. I can hear it one in the music, even though it's stupid that, you know, he got himself to this point. But intellectually, he's not fucking dumb. That's what really makes me admire him as a person. His overall personality, you can tell he was a well-meant human. You know what I'm saying? He had good intentions for others. You know, it's unfortunate, you know, that he led down that path of life. Let's finish this interview.
Is and that needs to change. And hopefully I'm one of those people that could bring that change. Or at least start a chain reaction for somebody else to come and do it after me.
So, to end this off, everything that Juice WRLD said in this video is really touching. It's nice to know that despite all the shit he's going through, he's also doing this for the fans. Now, yeah, you could just say that. You could just be saying it. But I genuinely believe it. I genuinely think that part of the things he was doing was, in the sense of, like, music-wise, was for the fans, because he knew that the fans could relate, and we appreciate that kind of stuff. You know what I'm saying? It's not every artist does it. Like I said in one of my other videos, reviewing one of the other songs of this album, he tells a story with all his songs. In such a unique way that not very many artists can, and at least if they do, it's not to the same level. You know what I'm saying? You know, and that's something to me that I think makes it even more sad that he's gone, because the potential that he had to be making songs, the amount of unreleased music that I have on YouTube Music as a playlist, click it down below. I'll link it if I can. If not, just click my channel name and go to my playlist, and it's a public playlist called Juice WRLD Bangers. 549 songs plus. Actually, I think it's more than that, because I added this album that we're listening to. So, it is really nice to see that he understands people value his music, you know what I'm saying? It's not like he's blind to that. Now, he's said that in a lot of other songs, in a lot of his songs, that he realizes he has an influence on people. And I think that it's really, really heartwarming to realize that despite he's going through this shit, he also wants others to get over this struggles and bullshit with him, you know? He doesn't want to be the only one. He wants others to know that they can do it too, is basically what I'm trying to say. And that's something he does talk about in his music, which I think that is great energy. That's pretty much that, man. I could talk for hours, to be honest with you, about this interview. I think that the words that he said, the way he worded his sentences, his answers, are very well thought out. Especially considering, you know, the way he acts off, like not in an interview, but like on camera, with that like get up and go attitude kind of deal. Intellectually, to be the way that he was is really, really, really interesting. It's really nice. It's amazing, and it really fucking makes me sad again that he's gone, because not a dumb kid. Anyways, guys, if you guys enjoyed this reaction, let me know. I'm so fucking high, dude. I'm really fucking calm, if you guys couldn't tell. I think I'm gonna start doing fucking yoga after this, and just continuously repeating myself saying namaste. Anyways, guys, thank you guys for watching.